Hello student, myself Nimesh Prabhakar. Welcome to Antenna and Propagation lecture series. In my last lecture, I complete chapter number 7. In that chapter, we have discussed about the parasitic element. Then we discussed about the jaguar antenna. Then we discussed about the folded dipole antenna and phase array. Now we start new chapter, chapter number 8. So in this chapter, we will discuss about the reflector antenna. And in this lecture, we discuss about the introduction of reflector antenna. Then we discuss about the type of reflector antenna. Then we discuss about the plane reflector. And last, we discuss about the corner reflector antenna. So in this lecture, we will discuss about this topic. So first, we start with the introduction of reflector antenna. The reflector antenna are most important in microwave radiation application. Antennas such as dipole, horn, slot, which excite the reflector antenna is called the primary antenna. So here in this figure, we see this is the reflector in the backward side, and in the front side, we have seen this is the antenna. This is a one simple horn type of antenna. So this antenna is known as the primary antenna, while the reflector we have seen in the figure and is called as a secondary antenna. The most common use shape are, that means in the reflector antenna there are the different shapes are used, but most commonly these three shapes are used. First one is the plane reflector, then second one shape is the corner reflector, and third one is the curve reflector is used. Now we discuss about the types of reflector antenna. So first one is the reflector antenna. This is a large sheet, or we can say large flat sheet reflector. So here in this figure, we have seen in the front side, or that back side, we can see this is a large sheet. And in the in front of that, we see this is a pivot element, is nothing but the dipole antenna. So here this dipole is act as a simply input feed antenna, or it is known as a primary antenna, and reflect a large sheet is simply it is a secondary antenna. Then instead of the large sheet, we can also use the small sheet. So this antenna is known as a small flat sheet reflector antenna. Then we can also use the simple element thin wire as a reflector. So this is a thin linear reflector. Then other types are the active corner reflector and the passive corner reflector antenna. Now next one types are the curve reflector with the front feed and curve reflector with the cascade feed. These are also the types of the reflector antenna. Now next one is the elliptical reflector antenna, and next two types are the hyperbolic reflector and circular reflector antenna. So these are the different types of the reflector antenna. Now we discuss about the first one, is the plane reflector, or is also known as a flat sheet reflector antenna. So here we see this is a flat sheet reflector antenna. The plane reflector is the simplest form of the reflector antenna. When the plane is kept in front of the feed, the energy is radiated in the desired direction. To increase the directivity of the antenna, a large flat sheet can be kept as a plane reflector in front of half dipole as shown in this figure. So here in the primary antenna, we have used the half wave dipole antenna. So we can see this is a plane sheet reflector, and in front of that we have placed this is the half wave dipole antenna. Now the main advantage of plane reflector is that for the dipole backward radiation are reduced and the gain in the forward direction is increased. we know that the dipole is radiated in the both the direction, that this and this direction. But we require the radiation in only front direction. So we can use this type of plant reflector. So in the backward radiation, we can reduce by using this reflector, and we can increase that energy in the front side. So we can increase the gain in the forward direction. To increase the directivity further, we can use the array of two half-wave dipole in front of the flat plane reflector as shown in the figure. Now, it is observed that the flat sheet is very less frequency sensitive than the thin element. So, only reflector element can be used to increase the directivity. So, instead of the large sheet, we can use this simple element as a reflector to increase the directivity of the antenna. Such arrangement is shown in this figure. The gain of lambda by 2 dipole antenna at a distance s is given by, we can write the gain g as a g is equals to 2 under root of r11 plus r loss, r11 r loss minus r12 into sine sr cos phi. Here this sr is nothing but the 2 pi by lambda into s. Now, for decreasing the spacing, the gain in the field intensity in the free space are shown in this figure. So here we have seen these three figures. So first one figure is s is equals to lambda by 4, that means distance is given the lambda by 4, and for that we can see this is the gain for that, and as we increase the distance like that, for the s is equals to lambda by 8, we can see this is the gain is increased. And according to that, we see. So for the different distance, we have the relation between the gain we can see here. Now we discuss about the corner reflector. When two flat reflecting sheet interact each other at a corner or at an angle, we get effective directional antenna, and it is known as the reflector antenna, or we can say as a corner reflector antenna. The disadvantage of plane reflector is that there is a radiation in back and side direction. So this is the disadvantage of this plane sheet reflector. So here in the plane sheet reflector, there is a radiation in the backward side, slight radiation in the backward and the side direction, that we can reduce by using this corner reflector. The shape of the plane reflector is modified so that the radiation in the forward direction only. The angle at which two plane reflector are joined is called included angle, and it is denoted by alpha. Now, the top view of the corner reflector is shown in this figure A. The figure B is indicate the front view of the corner reflector. The vertical corner reflector with filled petal along the main axis is shown in the figure C. Most of the corner reflector, the filled element is either a dipole or array of collinear dipole placed parallel to the vertex at a distance f as shown in the figure B. For the mathematical analysis, the dimensions specified are aperture of corner reflector, it is denoted by the dA, then the length of the reflector, that is L, and the height of the reflector, that is the h. The radiation resistance is the function of spacing between the field and the reflector. Now, we also discuss about the two types, active corner reflector and passive corner reflector. So, what is active corner reflector? A corner reflector with a two flat conducting sheet at a corner angle alpha and a driver antenna is called active corner reflector. That means in the reflector, if we use the driven element, then it's become the active corner reflector. The next one is the passive corner reflector. If the corner reflector antenna consists only two flat conducting sheet at a corner angle alpha without any driven element, then it is called passive corner reflector. So this is a two type, active corner reflector and passive corner reflector. The pattern of multiple image on the circular path for different angle are shown in the figure. So here the value for the different value of the n and the different value of the alpha, we get the different types of the reflector, like the when the n is equals to 1 and alpha is equals to pi, or we can say 180 degree, then we get the flat sheet or the plane reflector. When n is equals to 2 and alpha is equals to pi by 2 in the radian, or we can say 90 degree, then the square corner reflector. When n is equals to 3 and alpha is equals to pi by 3, that means 60 degree, then the corner reflector with the corner angle alpha is equals to 60 we get. And when n is equals to 4 and alpha is equals to pi by 4 radian, that means 45 degree, then corner reflector with the corner angle alpha is equals to 45 we get. Now in this lecture we have discussed about the reflector antenna. That means in this lecture we discussed the introduction of the reflector antenna, then we discussed about the type of reflector antenna, and last we discussed about the plane reflector antenna. In the next lecture we will discuss about the reflector antenna part 2. Thank you.